It turns out that there is one stable equilibrium and one unstable equilibrium. And now we'll discuss the details. Let's take this equation and put it in this form, so it's easier to see what has to be balanced. The force divided by the mass has to balance the deceleration by the brake. The force can be expressed with the help of the friction coefficient, the mass of 1/4 of the car, and the gravitational acceleration. So this equation boils down to the following: that the coefficient of friction has to equal the deceleration of the wheel over the gravitational acceleration times the ratio of the masses. And now we can check with our diagram what this means. If you brake with an intensity slightly below the optimum, the coefficient of friction has to be on such a line, slightly below its maximum value. This has to be the value of our coefficient of friction, and hence of the right-hand side. We have two options to satisfy this equality, and hence two possible equilibria, this value of S and this value of S. The lower one is stable, the upper one is unstable. I'll just illustrate one part of the argument for that. Imagine S was a little lower than the value of the equilibrium. Then we would have less friction because the coefficient of friction decreases. But if we have less friction, the brake acts stronger on the wheel, which means it's going to increase wheel slip. We are moving in that locking direction, which means upward. So from the left side, this equilibrium is stable. So when we are slightly below this equilibrium point, we are moving up. And you can argue in a similar fashion that we are slightly below that point, we are moving down. For this point, it's the other way around. If we are slightly below, we keep on moving down. If we're slightly above, we keep on moving up. So once we are past that point, we inevitably run into locking, a wheel slip of 1. And strictly speaking, there's a third equilibrium, which is stable again. When the wheel slip is 1, that means when the wheel is locked, the deceleration by the brake always supersedes the force applied through friction. We are going to stay in that locked state. There's a practical consequence of this. If you push the brake too hard, you're inevitably going to lock the wheels, which is far less than optimal. If you really stomp on the brakes, there is no equilibrium below S equals 1 at all. No matter what, we are going to end up with locked wheels.